Now, what I want to do for this practice is I want to go just like pair by pair and look at the following sets of molecules and determine, are they related to each other as isomers, meaning that things are connected differently, or are they related as conformers, which means that they just rotated into that position. So let's go ahead and start off with A, and then I'll let you guys try B, C, D on your own. So we see with A is that we have two molecules that look similar except for the top part. And what we see for the top part is that, let's say that I've got side, like a left side and a right side in this case. So this is my left side and this is my right side. And they're attached here to a central carbon here. What I see is that the left side has a double bond O, the right side has an OH, and over here, it's been flipped. My left side has an OH, and my right side has a double bond O. So are these related to each other as isomers or as conformers? What do you guys think? Guys, these are definitely conformers. And the reason is because notice that that swap of positions happened to a carbon that's attached to a single bond. Notice that the bond between the blue carbon, let's say, and the red carbon is single, right? That means that it can rotate as much as it wants. So if it rotates, my OH and my double bond O could easily switch positions without breaking the bond, okay? So as long as you have a single bond on your axis of rotation, you can rotate as much as you want. Now, how would I know if it was an isomer? If there had been a double bond here. Now, obviously, that would break the octet of the blue, so that wouldn't happen. But if you had a double bond there, then you couldn't rotate, right? Because double bonds and triple bonds can't rotate. So that's kind of the way we're going to think about it, okay? So hopefully this first example wasn't that hard. Let's go on to the next one. Try it yourself, and then I'll give you the answer.